Mars hidden ocean just found, and more stunning discoveries. Is Mars preparing to spill its greatest secrets after billions of years of keeping them hidden beneath its dusty surface? Here's the rundown on the game-changing discovery on Mars that just rewrote planetary science textbooks worldwide. In March of 2025, NASA's InSight lander, that stationary spacecraft that's been listening to the interior of Mars since 2018, detected something extraordinary. The data? Unmistakable seismic signatures of a massive subsurface ocean approximately 10 to 20 kilometers beneath the Martian surface. This wasn't just a small pocket of moisture or an isolated reservoir. We're talking about an extensive network of water-filled chambers throughout fractured igneous rock formations. Dr. Elena Rodriguez, lead seismologist for the InSight mission, described it as the planetary science equivalent of finding a lost continent on Earth. The discovery happened when an anomaly detection algorithm flagged unusual wave patterns that can only be explained by significant amounts of liquid water altering how seismic waves propagate through the planet. The scientific community's reaction? Controlled chaos. Within 72 hours of NASA's announcement, three independent research teams had verified the analysis. By the end of March, the European Space Agency had redirected their Mars Express orbiter to conduct focused radar sweeps over areas corresponding to InSight's strongest signals. Their preliminary findings provided supporting evidence from an entirely different detection method, essentially confirming the subsurface ocean throughout independent means. Not to be outdone, the Chinese National Space Administration joined the confirmation cascade in early April, releasing previously unpublished data from their Zhurong rover's ground-penetrating radar. Their findings revealed structures consistent with ancient groundwater pathways, connecting to deeper reservoirs, suggesting the subsurface Mars hydrology is far more complex than anyone imagined. What makes this discovery so revolutionary is how it builds upon years of incremental findings while completely reshaping our understanding. Remember the Phoenix lander detecting water ice just below the surface in 2008? Curiosity finding ancient stream beds in 2012? The Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter identifying those mysterious dark streaks that appeared during warm seasons? All these pieces suddenly fit into a much bigger picture. Mars didn't just have water in its distant past or in isolated frozen pockets. It has a current, extensive subsurface hydrological system. NASA's special scientific panel, convened immediately after the discovery, released their preliminary report on April 7th with this stunner. The volume of liquid water inferred from seismic data exceeds all previous estimates by an order of magnitude. In plain English, there's way more water on Mars than we thought, and it's in a form that potentially remains liquid and accessible. The timing couldn't be better for mission planning. Three separate Mars missions currently in development have announced rapid modifications to incorporate instruments capable of further investigating the subsurface ocean. The NASA ESA Mars Sample Return Mission is now evaluating the possibility of targeting drilling sites that might access materials influenced by this water system. What's particularly significant about this March 2025 discovery is how it reshapes our understanding of the habitability of Mars. The subsurface environment offers protection from the harsh radiation and extreme temperature fluctuations that makes the surface of Mars so inhospitable. As Dr. Sarah Newman of NASA's Astrobiology Institute noted in a press briefing last week, if Earth is any guide, wherever we find liquid water, we find life. This discovery exponentially increases the potential habitable volume of Mars. Analysis of the seismic data suggests this isn't static trapped water. There appears to be circulation within the subsurface system, potentially driven by geothermal energy from the interior of Mars. This circulation means nutrients could move through this vast underground network, creating environments potentially suitable for microbial life. Teams around the world are reanalyzing archived data from previous missions, looking for signals they might have missed. NASA has initiated an urgent recalibration of instruments aboard Perseverance to better detect chemical signatures that might indicate interaction between surface materials and the deep water system. Meanwhile, ESA's Mars Express is conducting the most comprehensive radar mapping of the planet's subsurface in mission history, with preliminary results expected by month's end. Just when you thought Mars couldn't get any more intriguing, it served up a chemical cocktail that has astrobiologists doing backflips of excitement. Mars isn't just a dusty desert world with some frozen water at its poles. It's a planet with a complex and active hydrological system that has managed to preserve vast amounts of liquid water despite harsh conditions. And where there's liquid water, especially water protected from surface radiation, the possibility of life increases dramatically. Here are a few huge organic discoveries that might rewrite the story of life in our solar system. January 2025 brought a major breakthrough when Perseverance identified the longest carbon chains ever found on Mars, complex molecules with up to 12 carbon atoms preserved in 3.7-billion-year-old mudstone. These aren't just simple organics. They're sophisticated compounds resembling those associated with biological processes on Earth. What makes these molecules so significant is both their complexity and preservation state, explained Dr. Lisa Thornton, lead researcher on the analysis. Finding them in protected mudstone deposits from an environment that would have been hospitable to microbial life when these molecules were deposited raises fascinating possibilities. February delivered the now-famous Chiava Falls rock, containing an unprecedented concentration of thiophenes, sulfur and carbon compounds often linked to biological activity on Earth. The discovery made headlines not for just what was found, but how it was organized. Dr. Marcus Chen of the Mars Organic Molecule Analysis Team put it simply, "What makes Chiava Falls remarkable is the specific arrangements of these compounds. Some patterns resemble those created by microbial mats on Earth. The distribution isn't random. These organics appear in distinct layers with specific organizational patterns that have triggered intense scientific debate. While alternative explanations exist, three independent laboratories have now verified the findings, eliminating instrument error as a possible explanation. The implications are enormous. We might be looking at chemical evidence of ancient Martian microbes." March revelations about Jezero Crater added another fascinating layer. Perseverance identified mineral deposits containing opaline silica, chalcedony, and crystallized quartz, minerals typically formed in hydrothermal environments. Translation: warm, mineral-rich water once flowed through these rocks, creating precisely the kind of environment where life typically thrives on Earth. Temperature estimates from these mineral formations suggest conditions between 50 to 90 degrees Celsius, exactly the range where thermophilic microorganisms flourish on our planet. "What we're seeing in Jezero isn't just evidence of water," explained Dr. Anisha Patel, lead geologist with the Mars Science Laboratory. "It's evidence of warm water loaded with dissolved minerals that would make an excellent microbial habitat." With all these discoveries pointing towards past potential life on Mars, do you think we'll actually find definitive evidence of past Martian microbes within this decade, or will it remain tantalizingly ambiguous? Let us know what you think in the comments below. Early April brought another piece of the puzzle with our understanding of the climate history of Mars. Advanced analysis revealed how widespread clay deposits sequestered significant carbon dioxide from the early Martian atmosphere, essentially functioning as a carbon sink. This process created a feedback loop. As more CO2 was removed, temperatures dropped, leading to less liquid water on the surface, which affected further clay formation. This sequestration discovery helps resolve one of the great mysteries of Mars: how it transitioned from a warmer, wetter world to today's desert planet without losing all of its atmospheric gases to space. The planet essentially locked away its greenhouse effect in its own rocks. Recent analysis has also clarified the relationship between the ice features of Mars and atmospheric composition. Rather than static formations, the polar caps interact with the atmosphere in complex seasonal cycles. During periods when the axial tilt of Mars was different, ice sublimation released significant water vapor and carbon dioxide, temporarily modifying the planet's climate. What emerges from these combined discoveries is a revolutionary new understanding. Mars wasn't just habitable once and then died. Instead, it experienced multiple episodes of habitability, with different environments potentially suitable for life at different times in its history. Even more intriguing is the possibility that habitable niches might exist today in the recently discovered subsurface water system. The impact on upcoming Mars missions has been swift and dramatic. The Mars Life Explorer mission has already announced the addition of specialized organic detection instruments. The European-Japanese ice mapper has incorporated sensors specifically calibrated for hydrothermal mineral signatures. Most significantly, the Mars Sample Return mission has completely reorganized its collection priorities to target rocks similar to Chiava Falls. Dr. James Moretti of NASA's Astrobiology Institute summarized it nicely in a recent interview. "We've moved from asking, was Mars ever habitable, to how many different types of habitable environments has Mars hosted, and might some remain today? That's an extraordinary evolution in our thinking." With each new discovery, Mars is emerging as a far more complex, dynamic, and potentially life-friendly world than we've ever imagined. The combination of subsurface water, organic compounds, and evidence of energy sources creates precisely the conditions necessary for life as we understand it. Whether Mars actually developed life, and whether any might persist today, remains one of the most profound questions in science, and we're now better equipped than ever to answer. If you think the surprises end there, you've got another thing coming. We might have new info on the most unique characteristic of the red planet. Can you guess what it is? While everyone's been buzzing about the March ocean discovery and the organic compounds, another scientific revolution has been quietly unfolding about the most iconic feature of Mars: its distinctive red color. For decades, we've explained the rusty hue of Mars through a simple narrative: iron in the soil oxidized, essentially rusted, in a process requiring minimal water, creating iron oxide or hematite. This matched our understanding of Mars as a primarily dry world. But recent findings from early 2025 have completely upended this story. January 2025 brought the colorful revelation that the predominant iron mineral responsible for the color of Mars isn't hematite as long believed, but primarily ferrohydrite, a mineral that forms under very different conditions. Dr. Jamal Kapoor, lead mineralogist on the study, put it plainly: ferrohydrite typically forms in cool, wet environments rather than dry, oxidizing conditions. This single discovery forces us to rewrite our understanding of how the surface of Mars evolved. The implications are profound and immediate. Rather than forming in a predominantly dry environment, the distinctive color of Mars appears to have developed through processes requiring significant water interaction. This discovery arrived just weeks before the March subsurface ocean announcement, setting the stage for a complete reassessment of Martian geology. The smoking gun came from Perseverance's detailed spectroscopic analysis in February 2025. While exploring the Jezero crater, once home to an ancient lake, the rover identified mineral assemblages consistent with long-term water saturation. The distribution patterns suggest repeated cycles of wetting and drying rather than a simple transition from wet to dry conditions. What's particularly fascinating is how these new mineralogical findings align with features that have puzzled scientists for years. The recurring linear slope, those dark streaks that appear seasonally on certain Martian slopes, now make more sense when considered alongside both the newly discovered subsurface water system and the revised understanding of the surface composition of Mars. These features might represent places where deep water occasionally interacts with surface materials. Following the March subsurface ocean discovery, scientists immediately began investigating potential connections between the deep water system and surface mineralogy. Preliminary analysis suggests that the ferrohydrite-rich surface might have formed during periods when the subsurface water had more extensive connections to the surface, possibly through now-sealed geological faults or during earlier periods in Martian history. The timing of this mineral revelation couldn't be more significant. With multiple Mars missions in development and the Mars Sample Return Initiative underway, we're entering a golden age of Martian exploration with a completely revised understanding of the planet. The discovery that the color of Mars predominantly comes from water-formed minerals rather than dry oxidation processes fundamentally changes how we interpret virtually every surface feature we observe. In early April, research teams began revisiting archived spectroscopic data with new algorithms designed to distinguish between ferrohydrate and hematite signatures. This reanalysis promises to provide a more detailed map of the surface composition of Mars and water history, potentially revealing patterns that connect to the newly discovered subsurface ocean system and the organic-rich deposits. Perhaps most exciting is how these discoveries connect to Martian meteorites found on Earth. For years, scientists debated unusual mineral formations in these meteorites that seemed to indicate more water interaction than the supposed dry history of Mars would suggest. The January 2025 ferrohydrate finding and Mars subsurface ocean discovery finally provide the missing context. These meteorites weren't anomalies, but were actually providing accurate clues about the true nature of Mars all along. As we piece together all these discoveries, the massive subsurface ocean, complex organic molecules, and now the water-formed minerals creating the iconic color of Mars, a new picture of our planetary neighbor emerges. Mars isn't the simple, dead desert world we once imagined. It's a complex, dynamic planet with a rich history of habitable environments and potentially even current niches where life could exist. What's clear is that the story of Mars is far more intricate than we ever imagined. The red color that has captivated human observers for centuries isn't evidence of a dry, lifeless world, but rather the signature of a planet shaped by water, the essential ingredient for life as we know it. If you've enjoyed this Mars Discoveries Roundup, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more breaking space science news. And let us know in the comments which of these discoveries you find the most exciting: the subsurface ocean, the organic compounds, or the revised understanding of the iconic red color of Mars. And as always, stay insanely curious.